Hey guys, welcome back to Feed the World 2. We're here at the Chilliwawa HQ, but today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. You know what we need? Well, last episode we looked into railcraft, but what we need if we're going to go forwards with trains is a train station. Now, there's a plot of land right next to Chilliwawa's HQ. In fact, it's just over here to the right-hand side of it, and I figure it's the perfect place for a train station. So what does a train station have? Well, I'm going for like quite a conventional design. I'm going to have a small train station because we're not going to do much here. In my mind, what we really want to do with the train station is be able to send our chilies to all the other players in the world. So this is the best place for us to stock up on our chilies and send them off to people that we're selling it to. So we're going to need a whole bunch of platforms to start with. And so you can see me here at a stone brick creating these platforms. Now we've created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 prongs that are going to stick out, and that gives us space for about 4 tracks. Now we're going to be carting chilies off to other players to sell them, but that's not all we're going to be doing with trains. We're also going to use them as a mode of transport. Also, if I need any resources at the Chilliwawa's office, the train station is the best place for us to go to cart them back and forward. Now, I know what you're saying, Sjin, there are pipes in the game, they're quite cheap. Why don't you just use pipes to do everything? You can pipe items to and from the office, from the farm, or wherever, but I don't think pipes are as fun. I want to explore the trains mod, I want to explore railcraft, and I want to explore Steve's carts, so we're going to build a train station so that we can send out our trains and have a lot of fun with those. Now, I'm using carpenter's blocks as the roof for the main train station platform, because all this is really going to be is a large waiting area and a bunch of platforms. I've designated a space to the right of all the platforms that's just going to stay as a big open square for the time being, because I might need certain places here near the train station for us to load and unload with various types of machinery. Now I'm using carpenter's blocks on top for the roof, and I'm coming out from the greenhouse to the left and building a triangle-shaped roof. And I want to keep it red. Now, to stop the whole building from being too straight, I added some leaning-out sections on the roofs that come out just a little bit over the open spaces where the track's going to lie. And also, I wanted to build a tower right in the middle. So I used white marble brick built upwards and had a little bit of like a clock tower, kind of, like you see on most conventional train stations. Obviously, we don't need a clock in the game, and we can't actually put one there. So what we're doing for the time being is putting a fancy Chilliwawa's poster right up there so that everyone knows this is the Chilliwawa Choo Choo. But that's it for our train station build. I've had a lot of fun making this train station, but now it's time to jump in game and actually put some tracks and things down so that we can get these choo-choos running on time. Whew, what a build. Oh wait, hang on, whoa. Ooh, ah ha ha, what a spot. Oh wow, look at that. I did not know this. Okay, so I've basically found a Thormcraft node. This is a magical focal point in the world that I can steal lots of magic from. But if you look, it's really hard to see without a thermometer. There it is, an aura node. But if I look at it through the thermometer, it's really bright. So that means we could probably look around at stuff and see these bright nodes in the distance. Oh, okay, well, let's extract some information from this. There is a bunch of terror and order in this. Now that's order, and I think terror is earth. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break it. Ooh, did you hear that? And I gathered the node. I gathered all that useful stuff. 6 ethereal and 6 terra. Is there anything else lying around on the ground? Now, I'm not sure if that's what I'm supposed to do with aura nodes, because I'm not experienced enough with them yet. I'll have to do some research in Magic Police. But that's pretty cool. Okay, forgetting aura notes, let's go over here and take a look at the train station. Oh yeah, happy days. I am super happy with this build. This is a lot of fun to do, and I can't wait to get cracking building some trains. Now, obviously, we're going to need a couple of things. We're going to need some train track, because that's how trains get around. I've got a big square here that I'm probably going to put some chests and things on here. I'll put some barrels around the back, and I'll fill those barrels up with some chilies, and then I can just pipe the chilies into the trains, and then I can just send that train off to, I don't know, Hat Films, and they can send the train back with a payment. That's a super cool idea. Now, I needed a way to connect this to the building, because I didn't want you to have to come all the way around the front to get to the train station. So what I've done is, I've built a cool little entrance here. Again, I've used carpenter's wedge blocks because they look pretty cool. Oh no, I'm still in creative from flying around and filming myself build. So let's just turn off creative mode. Whoop, all right, so I'm back in survival, but uh-oh, this guy doesn't like me. Better take him out, nice. Right, okay, so let's head back upstairs and I'll show you guys what I've done to decorate this place and make the entrance a bit easier to get to. So obviously you come out here and this is the train station. We've got a nice big room here. I'm not sure what we're going to put in here. Maybe like some waiting areas because people might want to wait indoors if it's raining or if it's cold outside, they can come in here. Oh, maybe we can have a buffet here or a cafe or a Chili Wowers branch. So obviously people waiting for the train can come and get themselves some red hot chili. Right, so moving on with the tour, you can see this hooks up to the main stairs. So you can come up here, you can go left or right to reception, or you can go out back and go to the train station. Now what that means is we can dig out this way. We won't do it yet, but we can dig out that way towards whatever's the other side of the Chili Wowers factory. So we can dig out that way towards the other side of the Chili Wowers HQ and just basically decorate the place and put some, you know, have a way for us to get out that way. Oh, I'm running low on health, so I'm just gonna have some chilies. All right, looking good. Now we're staying on top of the greenhouses and look, plenty of chilies are growing in here. Lovely. But what we're going to need to do is find a way to farm these. Now, originally, I thought I could do it with trains. I thought we could get a train set up that would go around and suck up all the chilies. I was wrong, because Steve's carts, farmer carts, there's like actual carts that have like combine harvesters on them, and they go around and they suck up all the wheat, all the carrots, all the potatoes, but they only do vanilla crops. They don't do anything else. So what we're going to do this episode is make ourselves our first train. Now this is going to be pretty exciting. Now I've had a look in Steve's carts, and if I type at Steve's carts, you can see all the different types of things you can make. Now this is the basic farmer, which is what you put on a cart, and that makes it a farming cart. But you can do other things. You can put a drill on your cart, and that makes it a digging cart. But that's kind of complicated because when you dig with a cart, you don't have any track in front of you, so you have to place it down as you're going along, and it's very, very complicated. We've also got things like a control system, invisibility core. You can make invisible minecarts. That sounds pretty cool. A chunk loader. Oh, of course. So you put that in your cart so that the chunk's always loaded, so you can always see where you're going. A torch placer, so you can put down lights as you're going along with you. Oh, that's cool. Whoa, an advanced shooter. That sounds amazing. Oh, guys, imagine if we had a railway track going all the way around our farm with all these little carts on it with machine guns. And if any enemies come anywhere near, they open fire. Oh, that sounds amazing. But we're getting ahead of ourselves because we need to fix up a few things. Now, I put in another coke oven here and an open block tank section for the creosote. And if we right click here, we'll find, oh yeah, there's plenty of cold coke in there. And we've maxed out our creosote oil. So I'll just take out the cold coke. But we've got a little bit of a problem here because now if we put any more coal in there, there isn't room for any more creosote oil in those things. So I've gathered some things I'm going to need for Steve's carts. I've got some PCBs in here for making the mine carts. But I've also got some fluid ducts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place those down. Have I got my... Yeah, there's my crescent hammer. I'm going to suck out the creosote oil and put it into these open blocks tanks. Now, I think you have to suck the fluid out from a coke oven from the top. So I'm going to grab some wood, I think, to use as stairs to get on top of this thing. Right, so if I just put one there, and if I put one there, and now I can get on top. Okay, sweet. So I'll put a fluid duct there, I think, and just suck along here. Glug, 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 glug. And then another one here. Blub, 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 blub. And then another one here. Blub, 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 blub. And then this is going to go all the way to you get, whoops, not the wall. That's a silly place to take the creosote. We are going to put the creosote right in that open blocks tank. Are you ready, guys? I'm super excited. Are you excited? I am so excited. So let's get the crescent hammer out. Set these to pull. Is it going to pull? And another one. Glug, glug, glug. Can you hear that? I can hear running water. But maybe that's the water from downstairs. And glug, glug, glug. But, oh yeah, it looks like we're not pulling out from the right side. Maybe we have to take it out from the side. Ooh, it's a bit glitchy. I got you now, though. Right, so lever in position. Now let's try it. Oh, there we go. That was what was missing. Of course, silly me. So we'll put some more wood here. And some more. Oh, I need another lever. But that should get... Oh, yeah, you can see already the open blocks tanks filling up thick and fast with creosote. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's like Transport Tycoon. Now, eventually what we're going to do is Chili Wowers is going to export and import from all across the globe. Oh, I can't wait to see that happen. Okay, let's chuck that there. Glug, 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 glug. Oh, look at this. No, whoa. We're going to need some more open blocks tanks because this thing's filling up real quick. Oh, no, no, look. This thing's almost completely empty now. So now it's sucking from here. And then last but not least, there. So, okay, right. Oh, it's filled up in a weird way, actually. It's sucking from this oven first, then this one, and now this one, which means that the end one's full and we still can't use it. Well, I'm going to need some more tanks. But never mind. At least we know that we've got creosote now and loads of it. So we can use all of that to make some railway tracks. So how do you make railway tracks with railcraft? Let's take a look. Now, to make a standard track in Minecraft, now there is a cheeky way about doing this in Minecraft. What you can do is just use sticks and copper. But if you use railcraft, you can get a lot more, a lot quicker. You can get 32 per recipe. So let's see how we make first the wooden rail bed. You need 4 wooden ties. And to get wooden ties, you need a bottle of creosote and some wooden slabs. So let's get a whole bunch of wooden ties first. Oh, I'll get some iron first, because we're going to need a whole bunch of this, and I might as well just use a whole stack on making these rails, because we're eventually going to need a whole ton. Now, luckily, I've got some power. Oh, I hear a zombie. Now, I need some power, but luckily the windmills are in full effect. It must be a windy day outside. Doesn't look it, though, not through this fine tinted glass. Okay, so let's just plunk these in like this. Whoops. Oh, wow, look, it automatically redistributes these things. That's really cool. Oh, that's a really cool way of doing it. All right. Wow. Bam. 8 standard rails. 16 standard rails. This is super quick. Right. Okay. Let's put some wood in here and make some slabs. Bam. And, oh, last but not least, we're going to need some creosote to make these ties. Now, I've got myself a stack of bottles. I prepared some of these earlier. So now let's stick the bottles full of creosote. Glug, 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 glug. So a wooden tie is a creosote bottle and a whole bunch of slabs. Bam, 16. Bam, 21. Bam, 24. Now, how many are we going to make with all of these? Oh, no, no, we need wooden ties in the middle. But we need to make a whole bunch of them. Let me just get rid of those. So we make wooden ties into wooden rail beds. We get 6 of those. Now we put around the edge these steel rails and bam, whoa, suddenly we've got 3 stacks of track. Now, do you think that's going to be enough to get us over to the farm? I don't think so. So we're going to use the rest of this creosote, because we've got loads of it now, to make as many of these wooden ties as we can.